long as this people let me go. So when I come to the end of the road, and the sun has set for me, I want no lights in a gloom-filled room, my cry for a soul set free. This be a little, but not too long, and not with your head bowed low. Remember the love that we once shared. Miss me and let me go. For this is the journey that we all must take, and each must go alone. It is all part of the Master's plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick apart, go to the friends and family that we know, and bury your sorrow in doing a good deed. Miss me, but let me go. I'm grateful for my father. And I'll miss him. He led a good fight throughout his life, and as a father, I think he provided well for each and every one of us. Times are tight, a lot of the time, but we always had a roof over our head. We always had food on the table. You know, he's a man of many talents, and as an artist, that was one of his talents that lended itself well to his occupation as a renderer and designer. He was a published author who, over the course of his life, researched and compiled the history of the Pacific War and World War II. I don't know whether it was the late 50s or early 60s, but if you talk to my dad, he figured nothing could be done without a manual typewriter and a silk ribbon. And so in the den, there was a stack of unnumbered papers of this history that he compiled. And one of our sisters, who remained nameless, and in there played snowstorm with them, with his history. So again, keep in mind the pages weren't numbered, so yet again he had to recompile his history. And ultimately, you can find this history on the back table, which A Whole New Navy, which he had published. I want to thank Roger, who held his hand through the publishing process, and all of us that helped him out through figuring out what it took to make the computer work. I think you still might find his cold, stiff fingers on that background. Our father was knowledgeable in many fields. Give him a topic, he could talk about it and go in depth, in great depth on just about anything and everything. I was always a little envious. His ability for recall far surpassed mine. He was passionate politically and actively engaged in the issues of the day. In his college years, he would participate in the lunch counter sit-ins. This was during the early days of the Civil Rights Movement. He had an opposition to the war in South Vietnam. He was very involved in that. He had concerns over the cost that war was going to affect on not only the people of the U.S., but also the South Vietnamese. In later years, referred to find him out on the street corner with the Seniors for Peace. Again, actively involved so grateful that he moved us here. And what this area has to offer is unique. I have members of Kings Canyon and Sequoia. The summers I've enjoyed out there with the St. Clairs. I can remember one time he took us out to the desert. Got exposed to that. I can remember one ill-fated trip to Yellowstone with the Meisters and my grandfather Smith that ended in foul Nevada, and we actually got to camp out in City Park there. There was a couple trips up to Oregon that we took with him. I can remember him taking the family up to Crater Lake, up to the Olympic Peninsula in Washington, and on the Canyon, Canada. And then later on, he and I did a couple trips up into the Redwoods in Northern California and Oregon. To this day, when the din of the city gets loud and the pace of life becomes too frantic, I find solace in the woods. Whether it's a quick trip up Mount Tam or extended backpacking trips into Sierra or Brandon and I a couple years back did the Lost Coast together. But this is a passion that has been passed down through the generations from our father to us, to our children, our grandchildren. I'll miss my dad. He's got a home for a mother. His love for her was complete. The passing of her was something he never got over. He married Ethel, and even still he grieved the loss of her mother. And Ethel was a wonderful person, is a wonderful person. She was that soothing influence on her father, on Bridget. Miss me, but let me go, for this is a journey that we all must take. And each must go alone. It is all part of the Master's plan. It's step on the road to hope. You know, spiritually, our father was sort of unsure about the presence of a higher power or heaven above. But this verse on the Bible says,
I'm Phoenicia, I'm a grandchild. And truth be told, she would have said a step-grandchild. I will put that out there, even though we really don't treat each other as all the refer differently when you were there. So I had two things I wanted to talk about. I was, one of the things, and I wasn't planning on it, but then we were talking about it in the car driving up here, and Grandpa Harry had gotten a Fiero. And, okay, so car roughly this big, and a grandpa roughly this big. So that's fun, right? You can, Francis didn't take me out to New York, San Jose. He came down with Jane, Grandma Jane, and he said, come on, we'll ride in the car. We get in the car, bring the clowns, and we get in the car, and we're driving around. And he says, I love this car. It's a stick, and I love the sticks. And I'm, you know, I'm 10, 11, 12, I don't know a thing about cars. And he says, never have an automatic, don't trust damn things. So it's funny, I was saying to Rick how those weird little ear things, like they get into your ears and you stick with that. And to this day, I love sticks. And to this day, I will hear in my head, don't touch the aliens. Damn good adults.
Yeah.